So in the previous class, we have completed the discussion of Wien-Bridge oscillator. Okay, right? Wien-Bridge oscillator was under the category of RC oscillators. Okay, two oscillators under the category of RC oscillators, RC phase shift and Wien-Bridge. Okay, right? We have completed. Next. Another type of oscillator that we are going to discuss now is the crystal oscillator. Okay, so here the main concept that we will consider is the piezoelectric effect. Can anybody tell me what is piezoelectric effect? Yes, what is piezoelectric effect? Please answer. Have you studied this earlier? Yes or no? Have you heard the term piezoelectric effect? Yes, students. Have you heard the term piezoelectric effect? Okay, see, anybody wants to answer? Yeah, I can hear some mic sound. Please answer.
Actually, Asma sir, do you know this word?
Yes.
So I said, no, we didn't listen about this.
You have never heard about it. Anyway, so piezoelectric effect means if you apply voltage to certain materials, okay, if you apply voltage to certain materials, then they vibrate, okay, right? And the reverse is also true. That is, you make the materials vibrate, okay, a voltage is generated across it, fine? So it is like this, you apply AC voltage, the material vibrates, okay, and the converse is also true. You apply vibration, okay, that is you apply mechanical force to make that crystal to vibrate, okay, then a voltage is, a AC voltage is generated across it, okay, right? So there are many details regarding the crystals, okay, but the important crystal that we use for our applications is the quartz crystal, okay, it is the quartz crystal. Other crystals along with quartz crystal which exhibit piezoelectric effect are Rocheley salt and tourmaline, okay, right? So, you can find the piezoelectric effect in these materials. One is quartz, Rocheley salt and tourmaline. Okay. But if you consider the mechanical stability and the cost factors, see, in any decision making, right, you consider all the factors and you pick up the best among the three, and that is widely used. Okay. Right. So, among these three, okay, among these three, what we have is the quartz crystal gives optimum results, okay, among the three piezoelectric materials, the quartz crystal gives optimum features, hence the quartz crystal is widely used in oscillators, okay, and what are the type of oscillations or the range of oscillations that these oscillators generate, they generate oscillations in the radio frequency range. Okay, so what is the general structure of a crystal? So it is like this. You have an arrangement in the form of a capacitor, and in between the two plates, we have the crystal. Okay, usually the crystal is a hexagonal prism, right? The general form of the the availability of the crystal is in hexagonal prism, but for practical use, it is stacked into rectangular slab. You can see rectangle, isn't it? Okay. So simple arrangement. You have a capacitor-like structure, and in between the two plates, we have the crystal, which is quartz, right? Then, what is the see? This is the structure, right? Now, in order to analyze our circuits, directly, if we put this in our circuit, we don't know what values to give, is it? So, like for transistor, what we did, we considered the equivalent circuit, and we use the equivalent circuit to do the mathematical part derivations. Then we understand, the performance of the transistor circuit. Likewise, what we do is we do not directly take the crystal for circuit analysis. We do not take this structure as it is and analyze. What we do is we consider its equivalent circuit. Okay, right? This is the equivalent circuit of the crystal. Right? This is the equivalent circuit of the crystal. This is the symbolic representation of the crystal, equivalent circuit of the crystal. Okay, right? And remember, whenever we are talking about oscillators, oscillator is a circuit which generates AC signal output. Okay, so definitely this is the AC equivalent circuit of the crystal, right? Now, why do we have these components in the equivalent circuit? It is, see here, when the crystal is not vibrating, in its rest position, means we did not apply any mechanical force, neither any AC voltage across it. Okay, the crystal is in rest position, then what it is? It is simply a capacitor. Okay, right? It is simply equivalent to a capacitor, and that capacitor is denoted by CM. Okay, mounting capacitor, mounting capacitance, it is called as mounting capacitance. Then, so we have considered two cases. When the crystal is in its rest position, means not vibrate. Okay, so the next case we should consider is when the crystal is vibrating, right? So what happens? Whenever the crystal is vibrating, there will be frictional losses, isn't it? Crystal is there, it is vibrating, right? So definitely there will be frictional losses, and that loss, is represented by this resistor R, fine? Due to vibrations, we have internal frictional losses when the crystal is vibrating, and that internal frictional loss is represented in the equivalent circuit in the form of the resistance. Okay. Then crystal has mass, isn't it? Okay. So this mass, which indicates the inertia, is represented by the inductance L. So it is like this. Suppose you have a heavy crystal, you have a thick crystal, then is it easy to vibrate such a crystal, or is it difficult? Which person will move around easily? Suppose there is a very fat person, very thin person. Who among them can be able to move easily? Yes?
The thin one.
Yes. Okay. So remember this in the coming, in the coming few paragraphs, we will discuss it. Okay. So it is like this. Here, the mass of the crystal is represented by the inductance L. Okay, mass of the crystal, which indicates its inertia, is represented by the inductance L. Okay, then what happens is when it is vibrating, okay, the crystal has stiffness, okay, right? The crystal has some stiffness and it is represented in the form of capacitance. So based on the features or okay, the, yeah, based on the features exhibited by the crystal during its off condition means not vibrating, okay, when it is not vibrating, represented by Cm, when it is vibrating, represented by the RLC, okay, and just now we have discussed what are these RLs, right? Now, the formula, have you studied series resonance, parallel resonance in 12th standard? Yes? Students, yesterday was, you have studied?
Yes,
very good. Okay, you know what is quality factor. Okay, yesterday I was going through some 12th standard books. I found series resonance, parallel resonance, quality factor, right? So we are not going to derive because it is 12th standard level. Directly you can take the formula. The formula for the series resonance, okay, the formula for the series resonance is given by 1 by 2 pi root LC. Okay, 1 by 2 pi root LC. This is the formula. If you want the exact value, it is 1 by 2 pi root LC into Q square by 1 plus Q square. Where Q is quality factor. Okay, I hope all of you know what is quality factor. Yes. Okay, again, I found one definition in 12th standard book. So I will tell the same definition. The quality factor is the okay voltage stored in inductor or the voltage. Okay, the quality factor is the voltage across inductor or the voltage across capacitor divided by the total voltage at resonance. Okay, so voltage across inductor, and we are considering the magnitude. Okay, so voltage across the inductor will be its impedance into current. Now same current flows through the three elements. So impedance is omega L, magnitude. We are considering only magnitude. Total resistance under resonance, what is it? Anybody answer? Just I am considering the RLC under resonance condition. What is the total resistance here? You said 12th standard you studied. So easy question. Please answer. Under resonance condition, what is the total voltage? Okay, just consider this branch RLC. What is the total voltage across this point and this point in terms of this? Okay, what is the total resistance at resonance? Easy question.
Z equal to R.
Yes. Z is equal to?
R.
Very good. Correct answer.
R.
It is. Yes. Correct answer. Why R? What happens under resonance condition? Okay. Anyway, I will answer that. Okay, so under resonance condition, again, just a quick revision of what you studied in 12th standard. Under resonance condition, we consider these, okay, the impedance offered by these two, zero. Okay, so what happens is the two impedances offered by the inductor and capacitor, they cancel out each other. Okay, that is resonance condition, isn't it? Okay. So, the L and C, the two impedances, they cancel out each other. So, we have only R. So, quality factor is, I said, voltage across the inductor divided by the voltage across the total, okay, series combination. So, voltage across inductor will be current through the inductor multiplied by its impedance. Total voltage will be current through the bands multiplied by resistance. Current is same. R, L, C are in series. So, whenever elements are in series, current is same. Okay? So, voltage is impedance into current. Okay? So, current is same. Right? So, quality factor is voltage across inductance by total voltage. Okay? Because current is same, now we can say simply the impedance offered by the inductance divided by the total impedance. Okay? Because current is same. Okay? Voltage by voltage, current is same. So, we take impedance by impedance. Right? Voltage is current into impedance. Right? So, quality factor, inductor voltage by total voltage. Current is same. So, we can say inductive resistance by total resistance. Okay? Yeah, exactly. Inductive impedance by total impedance. What is inductive impedance? J omega L. Magnitude omega L. Okay? So, simply it will be omega L divided by total impedance. Your friend has said R. So, quality factor is omega L by R. There are different what do you say? Definitions for quality factor. One of this is just now what I told. Okay. Another is it is the ratio of the resonant frequency divided by bandwidth. Okay. This is another definition. So, anyway, you can check out and you can just recollect what all you have studied in your 12th standard. So, the resonant frequency is 1 by 2 pi root LC for the series combination, right? Here we have square root of q square by 1 plus q square, where q is quality factor, okay? But usually for a crystal, the quality factor value is very large. The quality factor value for the crystal is very large. Means this omega L by R, if you consider the internal values, okay? And the frequency generated, right? In a practical crystal, usually the Q value is very large. So, because the Q value is very large, say in the order of 20,000 or 10 power 6, okay? Q square by 1 plus Q square. Q square will be, let us see the denominator. Q square will be even larger, okay? Q square will be even larger. So, the denominator, what we can neglect in denominator?
1.
Yes, very good. 1 we can neglect. So, what will be, if we neglect 1, what will the square root of q square by 1 plus q square become?
1.
Yes. Okay. So, very good. So, in problems, what you can take is resonant frequency. Okay. You can take resonant frequency as 1 by 2 pi root LC. Okay, you can take the resonant frequency as 1 by 2 pi root LC. Okay, you can ignore this. You can simply ignore q square by 1 plus q square. Right, and how will you get this one? Take series resonance. Right, I told you when the inductance and capacitance cancel out each other, that is where you have resonance. Means imaginary part 0. If you equate imaginary part to 0, you will get 1 by 2 pi root 0. Okay? We are not deriving because we have already studied that in 12th standard. Now, a fat person or a thin person, who will able to move around easily? We already answered. Yes?
Thin.
Very good. Thin person. Thin person will be able to move around easily. So, what, okay, is the relation? See, frequency means it is like moving, isn't it? High frequency means vibrating at very fast, okay? High frequency is vibrating at a very high speed, okay? So, a thin person, okay, can move easily, right? Say, let us take opposite. a thick person cannot move easily, right? So if the thickness increases, okay, if the thickness increases, then the frequency reduce. Frequency is how fast the crystal can vibrate, okay, right? It is associated with it, right? Frequency is associated with how fast the crystal will vibrate, and that will be responsible for the generation of the frequency of oscillation. Okay, so anyway, they are interrelated. So it is like this: a thick crystal, okay, will provide only low frequencies. Means if you need high frequencies, what should be the crystal? If we need a high frequency, should the crystal be thick or thin?
Thin.
Very good. Okay. For high frequencies, the crystal should be thin. But if the crystal is very thin, what happens? What is the problem? Will it break easily or it won't break? Yes? Yes. What is the possibility? Yes, very good. Okay. So if the crystal is very thin, it can get damaged, right? When the crystal is vibrating, it can get damaged easily. Means we cannot make the crystal very, very thin. So there is a limitation on the size of the crystal. Okay. There is a limitation on thickness of the crystal. It cannot make the crystal very, very thin. Means thickness is inversely related to frequency, means now there is a limitation on the frequency. That is, the frequency you can only have in the range of 200, okay, or 300 kilohertz. We cannot go for the higher, okay. If we go for higher frequencies, the thickness should be less, okay, but that will create the problem of mechanical strength. It can damage easily, right? So usually it is used for this frequencies in the range of 200 or 300 kilowatts. Okay. Now, here, if you see the equivalent circuit of the crystal, we have RLC connected in series. Okay. And then the capacitor CM connected in parallel, right? So there is a series connection, there is a parallel connection, okay? So we have to consider series resonance and parallel resonance, okay? So we have to consider the series resonance and the parallel resonance. Series resonance, okay, I already told you, it will be taking this imaginary part, which is the combination of L and C, zero. Okay. It will be 1 by 2 pi root L. That will be the series resonance. Now, considering the effect of the capacitor CM, okay, that is considering the parallel resonance. Right, again, this is 12th standard level, so we are not deriving. We will directly take the expression, but you can try it out, right? So the parallel resonance, it will be 1 by 2 pi root L C equal, okay? See, this formula very much similar to the frequency of oscillation in Hartley oscillator, Colpitts oscillator, okay? Right, very much similar, easy to remember, right? Anyway, so now what we are considering in parallel resonance is, we are considering the effect of this CM, okay, the mounting capacitance. So because of that, the parallel resonant frequency will be 1 by 2 pi square root of L into C equivalent, where C equivalent is CMC by CM plus, okay, the equivalent capacitance is given by CMC by CM plus C. Again, we are not deriving because resonance you have already studied in 12th standard. Okay, you can directly write down the expressions. Okay, then Next, we will look at the graph of the, okay, with the frequency, how the impedance changes, right? Now, let us see the circuit. With respect to frequency, how the impedance of this network changes. So, it is like this. When we change, okay, when frequency is very small, right? When frequency is very small, easy question. Okay, this we have discussed so many times. Low frequency, what whether the impedance is low or high for a capacitor or for an inductor. Okay, we have discussed. So, I want answers. At low frequency, which impedance will dominate? Among this R, L, C, which impedance will dominate at low frequency? Okay, anyway, for now, let us, usually R is a small value. Okay, usually R is a small value practically. So, among L and C, at low frequency, which has higher value, L or C?
Capacitance.
At low, C, why? Very good, correct answer. Why?
The impedance of C is 1 by j omega C, no sir, omega is 2 pi f.
Yes, very good. Okay, absolutely correct answer. Your friend has given absolutely correct answer. Okay, right. So, what happens here? Okay, what is your name?
Nikita Sharma.
Very good, Nikita Sharma. Remaining students also, please think and answer. Okay, if you think answer, you will learn here itself. Then very easy revising. Okay, final exam you have just have to revise and it will be easy, right? Okay, see, again I'm telling the electronic circuit analysis, all over the country students are struggling to get pass marks. Okay, it is becoming nightmare, literally they are afraid, they are running here and there what to do. Okay, but if you put your mind, while we are discussing, if you put your brain, it becomes very easy. Okay, right. Once we complete all the units, I will give maximum support for you to pass and score good marks. Okay, good students, right? But your responsibility to do the basics, that is class, whatever we are discussing class, you have to listen very well. Okay, anyway, so what your friend has said is the impedance offered by the inductor is directly proportional to frequency. Okay, impedance offered by inductor is j omega l. Okay, impedance offered by capacitor is 1 by j omega c, right? So when frequency is low, because the impedance offered by capacitance is inversely proportional to frequency, frequency is low means for low frequency, the impedance offered by capacitance is high. Okay. So, what happens at low frequency is capacitor offers very high impedance. Okay. And the impedance offered by the inductor is less. Now, if we gradually increase frequency, what will happen to the impedance offered by capacitance? If we gradually increase the frequency, what will, anybody can answer. If we gradually, see, now we consider first, if frequency is low, capacitor provides very high impedance, okay? So, when frequency is low, we have high impedance. This is x-axis is frequency, y-axis is impedance. When frequency is low, we have very high impedance. Now, if we gradually increase the frequency, what will happen to the impedance offered by capacitor?
It gradually decreases.
Okay, very good. The impedance offered by capacitor gradually decreases. The impedance offered by inductor gradually
increases.
Very good. Increases. Okay. But initial stage, the impedance offered by the inductor was negligible. When frequency was very low, the impedance offered by the inductor is negligible. So now the capacitor dominates. And because the impedance with increase in frequency because the impedance offered by the capacitor is reducing, the overall graph, okay, the overall graph reduces. Means, see, now we are considering the equivalent impedance of this branch, okay, which is the combination of R, L and C, right? So, due to increase, okay, again I'm telling, low frequency capacitor dominates, right, provides high impedance, so the equivalent impedance is high. Now, as we gradually increase the frequency, the impedance offered by capacitance reduces, so obviously the equivalent impedance reduces. Then, what happens? At sufficiently larger frequency, okay, the now the inductive, okay, now capacitor will gradually reduce, it will keep on reducing. Very high frequency, capacitor will act as short circuit, okay. So, the impedance offered by capacitance is reducing, simultaneously the impedance offered by inductor will what?
Increase,
very good, okay. The impedance offered by inductor will increase, very good, correct answer. So, what will happen here is, we have two effects, capacitive impedance, okay, capacitive impedance reducing, inductive impedance increasing, okay, and because of that, at a point, okay, at a point they cancel out each other, and the point they cancel out each other will be the resonant frequency, okay, the series resonant frequency. So, what will happen? The impedance offered by capacitance decreases, okay, and when the capacitive impedance is very low, then the inductive impedance, okay, is now significant. The inductive impedance increases, right, with frequency. But I told you at certain point, both the impedances cancel out each other. And because this is a series connection, the frequency where they cancel out each other is called as series resonant frequency, represented by, okay, series resonant frequency represented by FS, S for series, right, S for series. Okay, then, so far so good. Now, we did not consider this capacitor yet, okay, we did not consider this capacitor yet, okay, because, right, only for very high frequencies, this capacitor will come into picture, okay, for very high frequencies, this capacitive effect will come into picture. So, what happens is, again, here, as we increase, as we gradually increase the frequency, now the inductive impedance increases, okay, that we have discussed. After resonance, after the series resonance, the inductive impedance increases, and because of that, the overall impedance increases. But after certain point, okay, after certain point, this capacitor, the impedance, again, isn't it, as we increase frequency, the impedance offered by this capacitor will reduce, isn't it? So, this will start reducing, okay? This will start reducing, the impedance will start reducing, right? I have already told you, whenever you have small impedance, large impedance, the equivalent will be lower than the small impedance, right? So, anyway, as we increase frequency, the impedance offered by this mounting capacitor CM reduces, okay? As we increase frequency, the impedance offered by the mounting capacitor reduces. Because of this, again, okay, again, the equivalent impedance will fall, will start falling. And as we keep on increases, it will fall to zero. Okay, as we keep on increasing the frequency, the capacitor CM will act as short circuit. Short circuit means zero resistance. Okay, so the impedance will fall to zero, right? So these are the crystal impedance versus frequency. The overall crystal impedance, how it changes with respect to frequency, right? Then we have seen the expression for Fs, Fp, omega s, omega is 2 pi f, isn't it? So omega s will be 1 by root Lc, omega p will be 1 by root Lc equal. Okay, to cross multiply 2 pi to the other side, 2 pi fp is omega p, omega p will be 1 by square root of L into C equal. Okay, so we can represent the impedance of the crystal. Okay, so what is the impedance of the crystal? It is the combination of all these four elements, but usually R value is small. Okay, so we can neglect this R value, we can neglect that R value. When we see the problem, again I will discuss about the values. Okay, but usually the R value is small. So R value is small means we can neglect this R, and we can consider these components L, C and CM. Okay, so considering those components, the impedance offered by the crystal can be represented in the form, okay, using the series and parallel resonance by this equation. Okay, again we won't derive, but use the mathematical cases. When omega tends to zero, what happens when omega tends to infinity, and try to correlate with the expressions that we have here. Okay, right? So only 1 minute remaining, we'll continue in the next one.